And for that there are two attributes. One, there is no time limit. Normally we plan, if I want to do it, I will plan for next 5 years. No, these visionaries always plan for tomorrow morning. Second is, we think of a limit. And the limit could be sky, and I think they have reached beyond that. Sky is not the limit for them. This is what they proved. In this line, I have one more great man who is also in the Middle East with the same attributes. Can you guess it? Who? Our own director. R.K. Mishraji. So let us give a big hand to all of you. May not be knowing, but our faculty knows. Every day he tells us, I want to invest 100 crores for improving the infrastructure here. He says that he is going to bring the strength of the students from 240 to 1000. He wants to build a lot of things. Just like these two great leaders, Rana Som and Mr. Natarajan, are dreaming. Our director is also dreaming. And he has the same vision. He wants to bring a lot of new infrastructure. Like it was that these two people are also too benevolent. May I request Mr. Natarajan ji and Rana Som ji? Rana Som is already our corporate member. Natarajan will become a corporate member. Don't think otherwise. And Mr. Natarajan, I am told that you are getting a big order from the metro railway from Bangalore. It could be around 4,500 crores. So I am sure he will own one building called as PML building here. Why not? Rana Som is building a lot of things, he is robbing, you know why? Friends, let me tell you before I proceed. Those two good friends are mine. Rana Som knows me for the last 15 years as colleagues. Natarajan and me were colleagues for more than 11 years. So I know them very intimately. So before I really say that I am not a demagogue, to say that he is so and so, see, Rana Som was feeling embarrassed when I was introducing them, most dynamic place and all the languages. But let me give you a few anecdotes relating to Mr. Natarajan. When Natarajan and myself joined, almost in the year 97 in ECA, it was a real turbulence was there, and people were not really disciplined, lots of problems were there, and a financial crisis. And therefore, the entire workforce was always destitute. This is the time both of us joined. And an opportunity to work with Natarajan as appreciating that personnel too. He was insisting for discipline, asking only one question to the workers: do you want a weak management? Of course, we had a great leader by name Ram. He was asking, do you want a weak management? The workers said no. They wanted you to be strong. They wanted a strong people. In a public sector, you cannot expect direction in the pulse, direction in the class of your workmen. And myself and my great friend, C.L. Rao, who is sitting here, our executive director at that time, were working out how the company can be turned around. In that turnaround, we asked Natarajan, can you help us for reduction of your personal car by 5 crores? He said, done. He did it. It's a wonder. Normally, people will not accept such a situation where they want hike in their purse but never a reduction. It is possible. Natarajan always a go-getter. Let me tell you now. He knows how to get the things done. Because when I knew him, of course, when he had a full head on his head, and most charming, and of course, bewitching too, at that time, but now I find that after one gap, I'm seeing him, and with his bald head and all that, he's become more and more mature and learning most of his ideas for us too. I have to tell you a few anecdotes of him. Normally, persons, many of us try to avoid one. But as far as natural is concerned, he said, apart from these troubles of this union, officialization, everything, he said, he wanted to go to IT. He took the IT department of us, which was not at all, even at one single crore of rupees. Natural said, I want that division. You are not surprised how this man is saying that he will be a marketing man, he will do everything. Believe me, in every state he went there, and if you go to his house, perhaps you might find, if all the state chief ministers of that each state, he got our IT stations open. Everywhere we had IT schools of this, and the entire grid go to that project. In the year 2001, we got Excellent IT Award also, only because of it. Of course, I had another division called ECTV division, and I said, we must close it because it's continuing making losses, and the problems were again on him, because when we close a thing, we have a lot of problems. Irrespective of anything, what let me tell you now, the entire ECIA talks about these are board of directors, full-time directors, four of us. Of course, helped by our CIR as a turnaround team. And when Natwari left us in December 2002, I think that day normally anybody will get like bush, only from shoes. We had tons of flowers, every branch, everywhere, get tons of flowers, which was not edited by people. People feel that he should be with us. I still remember when our editor secretary asked him whether he would like to be the CEO of our ECAM. He said, no, I won't be a bigger man than this. So if you know, when he went there, his turnover was just 1435 crores. A very meager profit of around 35 crores. That's all, a 53%. He doubled it. And now he says, that's not my end. Now I want to see that it reaches 5,000 crores and profit is good. His profit is 6,300% higher than what he took over. 6,300% higher than when he took over. But you see his background, what was his background? He's not a technical man. He's only a personal director. But not only ECIL he has done this thing, turnaround, not only PML has done it, even a private company like Guinness has made a turnaround. Gentlemen, if I go on talking on him, it will be tons. But let me tell you one thing. We all went once to Abdul Kalam and he became the president. Because he was a former director too. Natwari made a poet. He read it to Kalam. I was really thinking what, why Kalam was trying to really hear all this. But still he said, as a former director and all that, he said, okay, all of you are, he's allowed enough time for us. After spending the time, he has read a lot of stanzas which were written by him. And at the end of that, Abdul Kalam was so pleased. He has written in tandem some big script on his book, Vision 2020, and gave it to only Natwari and none of us. Whom he calls DNS Chandu. Chandu had a big bag, whereas he got a bouquet. Chandu, he told, is most important. Of course, then he says, he showed me luckily my side also, and he said, finance man too, but not the finance man. Sir, today, all the CEOs in the country earlier are with people with financial background. So therefore, most of you who are doing your MBA course or whatever courses you are doing in personal finance,
now I request the Natarajan Chairman Managing Director of BEML Limited to deliver his distinguished lecture.
We must go to Dhanu Bhati. And I think both of them, Mr. Natarajan and also Mr. Ranaswamy, they believe one thing, we say in Tamil, when we achieve, we want him. Come what may, we succeed. And I think these two, they are an epitome of that. That's one. They are great sons of India. I don't want to say more than that. Because son, I think when you talk of son, even son and daughter, anything. But you have lots of expectations. And they have fulfilled the expectations towards society, towards people, towards different stakeholders. Both are dreamers, both are achievers, both are visionaries. They are great transformers, transformation leaders. They have got a missionary gene, and they have a tremendous energy flow. They would work not because the work is there, but they have a great passion, and both of them, I think, they believe in great change. Sir, my president, Professor Amar Rao, is away because he is a member of the Prime Minister's Security Advisory Council, the Economic Advisory Council, and you know, I think, the man of the country is very hot, so he is there, but he has asked me to convey his regards, and IP board, entire IP board, has asked me to convey their regards, and their salutations to both of you. Mr. Ranaswamy has been extremely busy, but we are personally extremely grateful that he agreed to present over the session at this for a couple of minutes. A great, a person with a lot of faith and a lot of expectation, whom I think we are extremely grateful that you are here. And now I think we request to Mr. Ranaswamy.
Mr. Shastri, your dear friend, and Mr. Natarajan, my dear colleague and personal friend of mine, my young friends who are here, and my colleagues from other TSCs who are here. It's a session to be taken by Mr. Natarajan. I just wanted to give a little background. You are all studying business management, especially students and profit. I just want to tell you a few words about what business is and how I perceive business to be. What is business? It's basically a process of conversion. It's a process of conversion of something to something. It's a conversion in terms of quantity, space, and time. You sow seeds this much and reap a harvest which is huge. You're making a quantitative transformation. You convert steel into machine, you make a qualitative transformation. You buy something up in Delhi and sell it in Hyderabad, you're making a transformation in terms of space. You buy something today and sell it tomorrow, you convert it in terms of time. So business is a process precisely which is engaged in conversion with the purpose of satisfying human needs and to make value addition and margin and getting profit out of satisfying the human needs. This is all business is. Our task as the managers of the business has only been two. Number one, how much value addition we can generate by consuming the minimum resources. And number two, how we can use the value addition for furtherance of our business objective. This is precisely correct. On the basis of these years' things, Mr. Natarajan has been not only one of the most successful business managers, he has been also an example for not only the business executives, but also the students who are pursuing management studies. I will not any longer stand between you and Mr. Natarajan. Hear him with patience, try to learn him, bother him, harass him with your questions, and that's what will be the best reward for you. Thank you.
Dynamic team of IT. I think it's a long awaiting invitation. I'm very happy, privileged to be here in this pretty much platform. Friends, I think I set the time about, let's say, half an hour. You will find admins, this way that is okay for you.
Yes.
You don't switch off at lunch time. I want to be alert. Okay. I thought I'll share about the business transformation that we brought about. I think I'm not going to talk much about government, but talk about general and computer government. I believe that, you know, you demand anything in life, you get it. But you leave it to chances, to subordinates, the team, and you may not get the best of what you want. So this business transformation is all about, you know, BPR process. You know, talk about that. They have all learned about the business process, re-engineering. Either you do a business redesign or bring about transformation. Complete, if you are in one business, suppose I have a business of running taxis. Tomorrow I want to run an aircraft, that's a business transformation. And then if you bring about a complete turnaround in a business which has been sagging, going down, nosediving, then you are able to make it a growth path. That's a business redesign turned transformation. I'm going to talk about that. How do we bring about business transformation? I think I'm singularly fortunate to have got the opportunity. I mean, somebody said, the temptation always rings the bell. But the opportunity comes only once. And I got the 2-3 opportunities for transformation. I grabbed it. I think I'm singularly fortunate to work for almost 15 years in private sector and in public sector. And I want to use both the skills. To my advantage, to advantage the business. I think that brings, I believe, sort of the improving results, whatever was it. I happened to work for a company called Bindi Le Kapra Wala. The company was there, 13,000 employees, 4 manufacturing plants, 5-6 businesses. And it had, when I took over, they were searching for somebody to get the HR all over India. They have interviewed almost 100 of people. Ultimately they interviewed me, and I went there. The CMD asked me, "You know, you look to be 35, 36. Can you manage such a big organization?" I said, "Sir, if you think somebody has to fill up your chair but not perform, you go for it. But you want somebody to bring about transformation, I mean loss making company to become a profit making, I think you can bet on me. I can tell you one thing. I will give you all the date of joining 100 resignation letter. The day you find I am unsuitable, you relieve me in the evening, I will go no more." Friends, I will tell you, I was one of the instrumentalities of bringing about it. Turnaround in BEM, I mean the Vinay's. It was 125 crores accumulated losses, 260 crores of loans that is borrowed from State Bank of India. All the properties of the company have been pledged. So at the end of the day, we brought, went to be a SIP company, we brought about transformation, we brought the reliefs and rehabilitation package implemented, we reduced 6,000 people, operation, the loss making operations. Then when a dominated union is around, you go through a very, very tough kind of other even at time, you know, threat to life. But we withstood that, came out at the first year of operation of implementation of the rehabilitation package. The the company made 48 crores profit. And the entire properties have been released. What happened subsequent to success is a different story. And this was the first taste of transformation. The second taste of transformation, which I came to ECL, the year I joined, the company did 259 crores of loss. The company became potentially sick. That's under the SICA Act, Sick Industries Companies Act, as a provision. Under the provision, if your net worth is the reserves and the capital. And the reserves and the capital, the net worth is more than 50%, then you are supposed to report to the government saying you are potentially sick. And that was the state at which we joined. And Shastri has talked about a lot on ECIL. Now we saw a scenario that everybody comes to the office, punch, lunch, if they feel like they work, otherwise they quit. The gate is open. And nobody to ask, nobody to question, just going highly indisciplined organization. If I have to tell you the height of my indiscipline, the chief executive officer officiated was made to walk 1.5 kilometers inside the factory by a crowd chasing him, and he was made to stand on a stool saying, "You hands on the transfer order." And he came and tried, he said, "I want to resign and go." The full-time CMD resigned and entered after now, and this has happened. The director personnel was looking at sky. I was general manager under him. So there was a meeting, senior meeting. Everybody asked what to do, what not to do. I said, "Sir, every chairman should go out to the company. So you have to take on these guys. I mean, you take on these guys, it will work." I think it went in for suspension of a few guys who mattered. That was the beginning of chasing the dog. The job was just this. I should not use this demeaning word I am saying, only to make you to understand the dogs are chasing you. But you took the turn. And I think that is the success of BM and the ECL coming out of woods. It made, when we left, I think it was 1,000 crores turnover with 100 crores of business. The company has been saved from the clutches of sickness and then getting closed. The point is, a lot of work went in. There will be no time to share that. I think we have a day to talk about it. I would have interviewed almost 100 executive non-performers. I said last 3 years when I went into the system, "Look, when you come for promotion, I don't want to interview you. Please put a presentation. Tell me what have you done last 3 years, what will you do next 3 years you have promoted?" Almost about 1/3 of the people did not come for interview. And we put a CSR. I used to go and stand before the main gate. I say, "Close the gate. No fellow will go out when I come in. If he has to go out, he will not come back." You could say, "Yes, sir, stop it." Everybody started working. People used to spend, I can go on. So discipline has been built up. Demanded performance. People saw there is no escape to performance but to grow. And company grew. It is merely managing human resources. It's not technology. It's not market. It's not product. It's people. It's climate. It's discipline. We built the discipline, we demanded performance, I think that came the growth of the company. Second turnaround. I think Bevel, I thought about it as we go on other you can go. Somebody said, "The gold is beneath your feet." I think I read a book called, "The Think and Grow Rich," Napoleon Hill. Somebody must have read it. Someone goes to a place, identify that there is a gold beneath. He digs it. Go to a place below 1 feet, the gold is there, deposit is there. But he got tired. "How long I will dig? No, my lifetime is gone." And he got tired, retired, went out. So when you are pursuing an objective, pursue to the hilt, to the underlying thing, pursue. Then comes excellence. Excellence doesn't come out of pain. Then every gain is out of pain. The pain is taking. The more people take the pain, the more gain will come. So all of us try to pursue an idea, but when it becomes difficult for me to pass, then we stop there. And then you abandon the kind of a goal. I think that is not the sign or a kind of a goal of a successful manager. If you want to be successful, I would like to only say, friends, in order to bring about transformation of business, we need to have a sense of what's happening around, a global sense. You need not to visit the all over the world, but you have a global sense. Okay, I am in this industry. What's happening in this industry today? What's likely to happen to the next 10 years, 5 years? Now, what is happening in the technology? What is happening in the market? Do I change? Do I remain obsolete, documented technology? So you need to have a kind of a global view of, overview of what's happening around. If that happens, friends, I'm sure. Okay. Now, as far as but before I could take you around this transformation story, I'll just give you an overview of Brahman. All of you must know what's happening around. We have revisit our vision. We said we want to become leader in a diversified company, as a diversified company supplying products and services here. This is the biggest complex in the gold field of India. That's called our gold field. We have four factories there. It's a Mysore engine plant and the concrete plant just behind the global development center of Infosys. This is our metro complex in Bangalore, very close to the airport of the S1 airport, close to here. When you look at the product profile, this is the entire ground support equipment that we make in the defense sector. The defense business is a mother business, you have the Ministry of Defense. Yeah? This is the various other products. This is the weapon loading system in the wings of the aircraft. This is the mine blowing. This is the CFP, crash fire tender, which can catch up to the 80 km/h speed in 40 seconds. Run around in the white aircraft. This is the ATT, which we are seeing, and this is the one of the secret projects of India. This is called a MOIST, on which you put an antenna. This can move on a vehicle, go to the border. I can tap the communication of the enemy and jam their communication. It is tapping and jamming. Tapping, I get the information, and I jam the communication so that he doesn't tap my communication, it gets disturbed. Yeah. This is the various products relating to the defense, the AI, to the wagons. The two wagons are primarily to transport the tanks, the fighter tanks. Yeah. This is one of the darling product of BML. This is the main battle tank. All of you must have seen, or somebody, some of you who have not seen. The main battle tank on a T-72, we have built an armored recovery vehicle. We are supplying in collaboration with the Poland. Yeah. And we are the leaders, friends. I would like to say, if you look at the kind of the entire range of mining construction, right from R&D to the 36 offices that we have in India, and we have 55 countries exporting, 4 global offices, Bemal is the second largest in Asia next to Komatsu in Japan, and maybe ranks 8th in the world. You want to improve our ranks. Yeah. Yeah, these are the various other products. Yeah. And this is the aggregates that we make here. Yeah. This is the underground equipment. We have taken over one of the workshops of the close to border gold mines in Britain, and we are developing some of the products. So we are becoming a destination for both the. We are supplying the entire range of equipment from small to the large in open cast mining, that's called surface mining. We are also now trying to get into underground mining, the underground products. I think there are no company in the world which are supplying equipment both for the surface mining, underground mining. We have that unique position. That one company which is supplying for both underground surface mining. Yeah? Entire range. These are right products. We make the entire range. These are electrical EMUs in Chennai, Calcutta, and the Mumbai suburbs, all you are seeing. And this is the second class coaches. We make various other solar products also. Yeah? This is the darling product. It's actually running in Delhi. It's going to be in Hyderabad. It's going to be in Bangalore, Chennai, whatever. So this is the metro product we are working with in collaboration with the Rotan Korea. And I think you will be riding it in Hyderabad. We are soon going to have it. I think we are set to order, set to back the order for today is in fact the final negotiation for Bangalore Metro, which are 1,800 crores. I asked for adjournment because of this meeting. So tomorrow we are going to have a meeting and finally decide that. Hopefully we will have the order in Bangalore. Yeah. This is various aggregates of defense, which goes into the tanks, which goes into whatever. Yeah. Now, our vision is to achieve 5,000 crores. When I took over, it was 24 crores, 13 crores of profit. Last year we did 2,700 crores of 348 crores of profit, which means 26 times we have raised the profit and almost doubled the turnover. And we have given from 20% we have improved our share dividend to 120%. I will like to share with you this at August gathering. Right. Next. Yeah, I mean we made various strategies how we achieve this goal. For the 5,000 crores can happen from 2024, provided we do a 12% of the CAGR. and annual growth. Annual growth in 5,000. Next. 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 So this is a summary of our corporate plan with the various business expansion diversification here. Yeah. So which will ultimately lead to 5,600 crores with annual growth of 12% with various interventions like, you know, expanding the market, giant ventures and whatever. Yeah. So coming to the finality of BML, I'm happy to share with you. There was a study done by it may be anybody has bought a lab on 1/1/2002, a share worth 1 lakh. The share has grown to 65,64,000 as on 1/1/2007. So that means we have given 6,564% growth in 5 years, or 5 years to the shareholders. Which is largest among the 247 rupees sector undertaking, fourth among the entire corporate including private sector. Yeah. Now, I already talked about, you know, we need to look at the organization, product, services, customers, and industry in order to understand the business and see where we go from here. Yeah. I mean, the members there, our friends, I would like to share with you. We are running out of time. When I joined on the 2nd of December 2002, I called my directors and asked them, look, what is your goal? Moment up, moment open the mouth. I said, I would like to set a site of next 5 years, 10,000 crores. They said, sir, 5,000 crores. So that's a 5,000 crores. That's a vision that's made out. We made a plan for corporate plan, we're going to achieve that. So this is kind from the day one. And then that goal is being pursued. And hopefully, we are talking about as per our vision, Revolution 13-14, we are thinking of going 5,000 crores. It looks like we may do it much before that. Yeah.